What's going on, everybody out there? Let's kick some ass, some manufacturing ass. Clotor Manufacturing, man. I'm here to teach you Mastercam, because I want you to be fucking better and manufacture for America and the world, and I'm here to fucking kick some ass and make you better. So let's do the first thing everybody always asks about with Mastercam all the damn time. Fucking dynamic milling. Let's get right into it. Get into it. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to start out like my tutorials how I want them to be. Okay, I'm going to go to my view. Turn the show axes on. All right, now I'm going to go to transform. So what I want to do is I want to do a dynamic, and I'm going to do a pocket. Okay, so let's make a pocket. You know what I mean? It's going to be very simple. Don't get overwhelmed. Just follow my steps. You'll be just fine, man. I believe in me. You will get through this. All right, click wireframe. All right, now I want you to click rectangle. All right, now the pocket we're going to make is 1x1. The outside is 2x2. So let's make the first pocket. 2. I put a 2 in there, and I'm going to hit tab. And I'm going to hit 2. And I'm going to hit tab. I'm going to hit anchor to center. All right, now I'm going to bring, see my square? I'm going to bring that right in here, and I'm going to see how it sticks, and I'm going to clip it right to there. And I'm going to hit blue to apply. Okay. Now the pocket I want to make is 1 inch, tab, Y, 1 inch. Bring that square over, hit bam. And then we're going to want to get rid of that. Okay, so now I know that the corner on this pocket, the radius here, is 125 thou. Okay. Shit. Sorry. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to go to fillet entities right here. Bam. Select that. Select this line and this line. And we want to make that, what did I say, 125? Let's just make it 1875. Okay. And then we're going to go to the next one, 1875. And we're going to just keep, see how I'm clicking this one and the next one. Okay, green check. Do you have them all selected out? So now what we want to do, I'm going to grab our machine. We're going to go to our default machine on our student software. And we're going to completely kick ass. So we know right here, if you go to your drafting, sorry, go home and go to analyze or go to dynamic. Sorry, I'm saying a lot of things. Go to dynamic and then grab this arc. And it's going to show you it's a 1875 arc. So now we know we can use a freaking quarter inch end mill right here and we'll clear roughly 50 thou. So we're going to use a quarter inch end mill to do our dynamic rough. So we're going to go tool paths. Hope you caught all that. And we're going to click dynamic. And then we're machining regions. Make sure we're inside. Okay, machining regions. Grab that BI and hit C plane. Okay. And grab it exactly where I'm grabbing it. Just try to, anyways, if you're very new. If not, you understand what's going on. Don't freaking hold me again. I don't care how much you know, by the way. I'm just trying to teach you, so relax. All right. So we're gonna green check that. Now we're gonna go into here and we're gonna grab. Select tool library. We're going to grab a quarter inch freaking flat end mill. Whoops. We're just going to double click it. So I hit select that. Okay, now we're going to double click it again. Okay, so now this pocket's going to be stainless steel, let's say, or any cold rolled steel or any cold steel or non-hardened steel or even pre-hardened steel this probably should work for. Let's call this tool one. Tab, 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 tab. Let's put in here 325 for your SFM, okay? Just a lucky guess. And then we're gonna go 50, 50, 50, 5 grand. But I know if you go like this and go 8 grand, it should be pretty badass. So hit finish, okay? So now what we're gonna do, a rough pocket. That's gonna be our man readable, rough pocket, okay? So now we're going to go down here, we're going to select our holder. Okay, so now the pocket's got to be 500 thou deep. So let's see, okay, our cutting length 500 thou, we're good to go, okay? We want to grab our holder. We don't want an ER, okay? We want a side lock. So this is a side lock right here. Okay, see how it looks like a side lock? Okay, we're going to want to go 0.75. Okay. Now, well, let's get into the meat and potatoes. So we're going to come in here. We're going to do an approach distance. You can always want to put a value in there to keep yourself a feed rate away from your geometry in case somebody loads the stock bucked up. Okay, and now we're going to do the first pass offset. Never touch it. First pass reduction, feed reduction. Never touch it. Step over for aluminum is 25%. Step over for steel, 10%. Okay, keep this at 10. Gap size. This is what I want to talk to you about as well. Gap size. Okay, we want to know the gap size is going to be how long do you want it to be in the feed rate before it retracts? Okay, my rule of thumb is roughly 3 inches. So I'm going to put 3 inches. And I'm going to do a micro lift of 0. A micro lift is when your cutter's in the cut and it lifts up and goes back to the beginning of the cut, that's your micro lift. So now, when you go to your motion here, you want to, when exceeding a distance, because you don't want it to stay in the feed the whole time and waste everybody's time. Operators don't like that. And you want to keep this at 250, put that in an exceeding distance, keep everything like you see here, and it will be successful. Okay, and we want to keep 10 thou, stock to leave on wall, stock to leave on floors, entry motion. Entry motion is going to be 0.125 minus a 32nd. This is my rule of thumb, okay? So you always want to drop some type of fractional, small fraction underneath the half point of the end mill. Okay, Z clearance, 0.05. Okay, plunge angle in steel is 1, in aluminum is 5. Okay, let's get to our Lincoln parameters. Let's turn this clearance on to 1 inch. Make sure everything's absolute. Retract, 0.1. Feed plane, 0.1. Top of stock, we want to go, what did I say? 500,000 deep. Okay, arc filter tolerance. We want to keep this 0.005. Close to how much stock you have to leave. And how much stock, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to really go over that. Coolant, of course, turn that on. Let's green check this, let's see what we got. Okay, that's all right. And to eliminate the ramp, you can do a drill. But just to show you, McMillan now, we got one tool that's gonna take to drill out this 500 thou deep pocket. Okay, we got the correct holder on there, we got the correct everything on there, correct length of cut. Okay, so now we know that's 500 thou, okay? So now what I want you to do is grab this, and then we're gonna go translate. I just selected this to get rid of that. We're gonna go translate, and we're gonna translate minus 500 thou, because that's how deep we wanted that pocket. Minus 0.5, we're gonna join, green check, okay? Right click, clear colors. Now what I want you to do is grab surfaces, loft, seaplane, and grab them on the same spot. See how the arrow is in the same spot on the, how I grab that? Green check. Okay, do the same thing again. No, don't do the same thing again. Green check, sorry. Hit flat, boundary surface, seaplane. Grab the bottom, green check. Blue check, seaplane. Grab the top, green check. All right, green check again. Now that's gonna get you your fucking shit. So we're gonna wanna drop this down, stock setup, all entities. Unselect display, green check. All right, now what we can do, if you followed all that, hit tool path, hit verified selected operations. Wait a minute here, because my computer's terribly, terribly slow. And now we're gonna see this sucker cut. Okay, slow it down a little bit. There it is, ramping in there. And now she's doing the boil out cut. Wah. There you go. So that's your dynamic, man. You know, it's just a roughing pass, this dynamic. You do not finish your part with that. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to do an outside dynamic to complete this tutorial. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to chains. So I went to transform, chains, select chains, hit seaplane. grab these chains, see how I grab that? Okay, hit green check. See, now we're gonna transfer, okay, offset, indicate offset direction, the same direction. You can see our line, the purple line. We only wanna offset it 100 thou. That's the size of the boss, okay? Let's join it, why not? Okay, green check. Now what we wanna do is grab, oh no, okay. Right click, clear colors. Now we wanna grab all of these lines. Just these lines on the very top. And we're gonna go transform, translate. It's a 100th thou boss. We're gonna go up 100th thou in the Z. We're gonna join. Okay? Now what we're gonna do, go to our stock setup and select all entities. Unselect display, green check. All right. Now, grab parameters here, linking parameters. We just changed the top of stock to 100 thou. So we need to, I selected top of stock and then I selected the very top of my geometry, which is 100 thou, green check. Regenerate. Okay, now what we want to do is copy and right click, go down, let go. And then we're gonna hit copy after. Now we're gonna go into our geometry and we're gonna hit from outside. Machining regions, I right click, rechain single, C plane. Here's the outside, okay? Sorry, rechain all. We want to grab the complete outside of your stock. Now we want to go in and grab our avoidance region, which will be the boss. Seaplane, grab around the boss. Green check, green check. Come in here to your parameters, go right to your linking parameter. Top of stock, 100 thou, your depth. Select that sumbitch, it should be right at zero. All right. Now, you're gonna do that. You're gonna make this fancy outside dynamic path. Let's be really fancy here. Let's go to your, I go to surface, go to loft, go to seaplane, and let's select this line and this line. And hit enter, enter. Now select this line, or no, hit enter, enter. Okay, now seaplane, this line, enter, enter. Okay, now seaplane, this line, enter, enter. All right, green check. Now grab both of these paths. Verify selected operations. And let's do a turbo here. There you have it. There's your dynamic milling tutorial. Thanks a lot, folks. Take it easy.